Hello viewers, welcome to MathTech. I am Amit Sharma. In this video, we are going to solve questions from 49 to 51 of chapter 2 from the book Contemporary Abstract Algebra by Joseph Galen. So without a delay, let's start. Question number 49. Prove that the set containing the element 1, 2 and up to n minus 1 is a group under multiplication modulo n if and only if n is prime. First, suppose that the set X containing the element 1, 2 up to n minus 1 is a group under multiplication modulo n. Now, we have to show that n is a prime number. Let, if possible, n is not a prime number. Then n can be written as product of a into b, where 1 is less than a less than n, here a belongs to x, and 1 is less than b less than n, and b belongs to x. Now, by closure axiom, AB under mod n belongs to x, but AB under mod n is equal to 0, which is not belongs to x, which is contradiction to that the set X is a group, implies our assumption is wrong. Hence, n must be a prime number. Now, we have to suppose that n is a prime number. Now, we have to show that the set X containing the element 1, 2 up to n minus 1 is a group under multiplication modulo n, where n is a prime number. Let a comma b belongs to X. This implies 1 is less than equal to a less than n and 1 is less than equal to b less than n. Since n is a prime number, this implies 1 is less than a b less than n, here a b is under multiplication mod n. This implies a b belongs to X. Since a and b are arbitrary element of X, this implies a b belongs to X for all a comma b belongs to X under multiplication modulo n. Thus, X is closed under binary operation multiplication modulo n. Let a b c belongs to X, where 1 is less than equal to a comma b comma c less than n. We have a into b c is equal to a b into c under multiplication mod n. Since a, b, c are arbitrary element of X, this implies a into b, c is always equal to a, b into c for all a, b, c belongs to X under multiplication modulo n. Thus, associative property hold in X. Let a belongs to X, where 1 is less than equal to a less than n, and 1 belongs to X, such that 1 into a equal to a into n under multiplication mod n. Here, 1 is known as identity. Since a is an arbitrary element of X, this implies a into 1 equal to a equal to 1 into a for all a belongs to X under multiplication modulo n. Thus, identity exists in X. Let a belongs to X, where 1 is less than equal to a less than n. There exists b belongs to X, where 1 is less than equal to b less than n, such that a b equal to 1 equal to b a under multiplication mod n. Since a is an arbitrary element of X, this implies for every a belongs to X, there must exist some b belongs to X, such that a b equal to 1 equal to b a under multiplication modulo n. Thus, for every element in X, inverse exists in X. Hence, X containing the element 1, 2 up to n minus 1 is a group under multiplication modulo n, where n is a prime number. Question number 50. In a finite group, show that the number of non-identity elements that satisfy the equation x to the power 5 equal to identity is a multiple of 4. If this stipulation that the group be finite is omitted, what can you say about the number of non-identity elements that satisfy the equation x to the power 5 equal to identity? In order to solve the equation, it is essential to learn the following results. Result number 1. A mapping phi from natural number to natural number defined by phi of n containing the element x belongs to natural number such that 1 is less than equal to x less than n and GCD of x omen is 1 is called Euler's phi function. Result number 2. The Euler phi function for p to the power n is equal to p to the power n minus p to the power n minus 1, where p is a prime number. The Euler function phi of m into n is equal to phi of m into phi of n if GCD of mn is equal to 1. Result number 3. For any x belongs to G such that x to the power k equal to identity, the number of non-identity element of G satisfy the equation x to the power k is equal to identity is a multiple of phi of k, where phi is known as Euler's phi function. Let G be a finite group and x belongs to G. Now, the number of non-identity element of G that satisfy the equation x to the power phi equal to identity is a multiple of phi of 5, which is equal to 4. Hence, the number of non-identity elements of G that satisfy the equation x to the power 5 equal to identity is multiple of 4. If group G is infinite, then the number of non-identity element of G that satisfy the equation x to the power 5 equal to identity is either multiple of 4 or infinite. Question number 51. List the 6 element of GL2Z2. Show that this group is non-abelian by finding two elements that do not commute. The following result is very useful in order to solve the question. Result: GL and F is equal to A equal to Aij n cross n matrix such that determinant of A is not equal to 0, Aij belongs to F, that is the set of all n cross n invertible matrix form a group under matrix multiplication known as general linear group. Now, GL2Z2 is equal to A equal to Aij 2 cross 2 matrix such that determinant of A is not equal to 0, Aij belongs to Z2, and we know that Z2 contains the element 0 and 1. Now, this is the element of GL2Z2. Let A is equal to 2 cross 2 matrix having element 1, 1, 0, 1 belongs to GL2Z2, and B is equal to 2 cross 2 matrix having element 1, 0, 1, 1 belongs to GL2Z2. Now AB, this is the product of A and B, which is equal to 2 cross 2 matrix having element 2, 1, 1, 1. And BA, this is the product of B and A, which is equal to 2 cross 2 matrix having element 1, 1, 1, 2. This implies AB is not equal to BA. This implies A is not commute with B. Hence, GL2Z2 is non-abelian group. Thank you very much for watching my video. If you like the content, please do like, share and subscribe my channel. If you have any query, comment me. Thank you very much.